Hey all, welcome to the initiative tutorial on how to look at the leaderboard. So to begin, go to your favorite web browser and
browse junior.initiative.in
and land on the contest page. If you are not already logged in, click on the register button on the top right corner of the screen and choose login to the contest dashboard. There, login using your credentials. Now that you are in the dashboard, you can see the challenges tab beside the home tab. On clicking that, you see the complete list of challenges that you can attempt. You can also filter the challenges out based on their name, date, difficulty, or solved status. As an example, I'll show you how RoboCorp challenge is solved. It's a beginner level challenge. Clicking on RoboCorp takes you to a new page where you see options to submit a flag, start an instance, and download attachments. Click on Start Instance to get started. Wait till Open Deployment shows up. Click here and you get redirected to the RoboCorp challenge page. I'm adding robots.txt to the link in the URL, which now displays a page showing a disallowed. Now, when I paste the code in the URL box, I get the flag. Once you get the flag, you complete the challenge. Get back to the challenges page and click on the Submit the Flag button and paste the flag there. Look at the description box to see if the flag you got matches the format. Since this flag was right, my score increased and so did the rank. If you submit the wrong flag, your number of attempts will be increased by 1. Solve at least one challenge to get into the leaderboard. Switch over to the scoreboard tab to see the stats of the people who competed along with you. You can see the details like rank, the number of attempts, flag, challenges, progress, points, last solve, and last attempts of every player, including you. Clicking on a player shows all the details of the player. You can see the player's name, username, and country on the left. This screen also shows the player's rank, the points they gained so far, the number of attempts they did in total, the number of flags and challenges they submitted, and the percent of completion. You also get to see your first, second, and third blood stats. First blood simply means the first person to solve a challenge. If you solve a challenge before anyone else does, your first blood count increases. Similarly, second and third blood respectively means the second and the third person to solve a particular challenge.
We will solve one more web challenge and see the rank go up. Getting back to the challenges tab, let's select the favorite cookie challenge. So like we did before, we are starting an instance and opening it, which takes us to the challenge page. On inspecting and clicking the network tab and refreshing the page, we search for headers and find a header named hint, which says only Oreo lovers here. We now go to the storage tab and open the cookies tab to see all the cookies on the site. We see the fave cookie as XXX. Guessing from the header we got earlier, type in Oreo and refresh the page. Now you see that the site is updated and now tells about giving the flag when it is 2030. If you remember, we saw a cookie named time earlier. We type in 2030 there and now you get the flag. Copy it and go back to the challenge page and submit the flag. You can also see the number of people who have solved the challenge so far and the number of people who attempted it. You can also see that you got 100 points. The maximum score is 2550. On checking the leaderboard, you see that your rank has gone up. Congrats! Once you complete all the challenges, the progress bar will be filled and shows 100%.
To see the tutorials to learn on how to solve the challenges in different categories, you can visit our YouTube channel. Thank you!